let us write the Newton's law of viscosity first on the old fluid mechanics sign convention. The viscous stress tensor tau is related to the strain rate tensor by the equation tau is equal to 2 mu d. And in terms of components, these are the equations. These are for the normal stresses and these are for the shear stresses. Left hand side we have the components of the viscous stress tensor, okay. And right hand side are in terms of the components of the strain rate tensor, which of course we have discussed, we are familiar with this. Now, what we will do is we will rewrite the Newton's law of viscosity following the new convention. What is that? New fluid mechanics sign convention or momentum transport convention, we already reconciled both of them and both of them have the same sign. So, what is new? The same equation but with the negative sign here, okay. So, now it is tau equal to minus 2 mu d. How do we interpret tau? If you are saying that new fluid mechanics sign convention, it is viscous stress tensor, no change in that at all, only sign convention has changed. But if you are saying momentum transport convention, then it is interpreted as molecular momentum flux tensor, okay. So, tau has two interpretations, one is viscous stress, other is molecular momentum flux. If it is fluid mechanics, it is always viscous stress only, only the sign convention is different. But if you are saying momentum transport, it represents the molecular momentum flux, okay. So, now just rewrite the same set of 6 equations including a negative sign, that is all, okay. No change at all other than including a negative sign. So, now what are these? The left hand sides are the components of the viscous stress tensor. Once again, if it is the new fluid mechanics sign convention, if you take a momentum transport convention, you interpret the left hand sides as components of the molecular momentum flux tensor. That is the new viewpoint, okay. What I discussed in the previous slide is a comparison between the one dimensional form of Newton's law of viscosity, the old and the new, which means that we have taken this mu and then dou Vx by dou y, and we have taken this minus mu dou Vx by dou y. So, we had all our discussions based on this one dimensional Newton's law of viscosity. We have just extended that to the three dimensional form of Newton's law of viscosity, okay. So, only conclusion from this side is whatever you have discussed for the simple form has been extended to the more general 3D form by including a negative sign. One other important point in this slide is that tau is now interpreted as the molecular momentum flux tensor, okay. Now, how do we write the total stress tensor? So, when I write the total stress tensor, we are going to compare the old fluid mechanics sign convention and the new fluid mechanics sign convention, okay. Let us look at it, okay. Now, where is the difference? We have discussed already tau. Only difference can come from the pressure term. Now, based on the old fluid mechanics sign convention, since pressure is compressive, it is negative. Why is it? That is what is shown. Remember, pressure is always compressive. That does not depend on whether old sign convention or new sign convention. It always acts into the control volume. So, these two figures are for the old sign convention. So, in this case, if you take a positive phase forces along the positive axis, which means that tensile is positive, compression is negative. So, this is positive and so this becomes negative, and so we have the total stress tensor as minus p I plus tau, which is minus p I plus 2 mu d. Okay. This we already come across. So, if you now write the components, if you write the this equation in terms of components, same as what we have seen in the previous slide, just add minus p to the normal stresses, no other change. Okay. There is no change in the shear stresses, because p is just a normal stress. Okay, now, the new sign convention, pressure is again compressive, that cannot change, please keep that in mind, but now becomes positive. Why? These two figures are shown based on the new sign convention. Here on a positive phase, forces along the negative direction. Now, look at these two arrows, they are representing compressive forces and they represent a positive stress tensor component. So, the pressure which is compressive in the new sign convention becomes positive. Okay. So, now let us write down the total stress tensor. What is the change? Minus p I becomes plus p I, of course, I is the unit tensor. So, instead of minus p I plus tau, we have plus p I plus tau. Now, of course, this is p I. Now, if you write tau in terms of the strain rate tensor, it is minus 2 mu d, which you have seen in the previous slide. Okay. So, in terms of hierarchy, first all the discussion was based on one dimensional Newton's law of viscosity. In the previous slide, we extended that to the three dimensional form. Now, we are further extending and writing the total stress tensor. Okay. Okay. So, very simple, whatever expression we had in the previous slide based on new sign convention, add a plus p to the normal stress components, okay. Because we are still in fluid mechanics, new sign convention, tau represents only viscous stresses. Okay. Okay, so to summarize this slide, pressure is compressive, but it is negative in the old sign convention, positive in the new sign convention. Okay, that kind of summarizes this slide. Now, what is the implication of our discussion on the linear momentum balance? Now, what we are going to do now is derive the linear momentum balance in three different ways. First is fluid mechanics old sign convention, then fluid mechanics new sign convention, and then the momentum transport convention. Okay. Now, this is just a recall, whatever we have done earlier for 3D case, 3 dimensional control volume, here we are going to do for 2 dimensional control volume. So, we will just only list the important steps. Okay, so, we will start at the integral form of the linear momentum balance, that is what we did. We took the integral form of linear momentum balance and applied that for a small control volume, okay, 3 dimensional control volume. What we have here is a 2 dimensional control volume, okay, for sake of simplicity. So, what we have is the integral linear momentum balance for a fixed control volume, the transient term, the convection term, then right hand side we have body forces because of the gravitational force, and then the surface forces because of pressure and viscous stress. Okay. I am stressing this, you will understand why I stress this here. Okay. So, like to repeat, transient convection on the left hand side, right hand side body and surface forces, and body force because of gravity, surface force because of pressure and viscous stress. Okay, now, let us look at this control volume quickly. All the required quantities are shown here in one diagram. Earlier when we derived, we had different control volumes. Okay. Now, let us look at them. Okay. The lengths are delta x and delta y, and then these blue arrow marks represent the convective momentum in and then out. Remember, all of them refer to x momentum, the second velocity is Vx, and this is because of mass flow in x direction and this is because of mass flow in y direction, entering at x, leaving at x plus delta x, entering at y, leaving at y plus delta y. So, all the blue colors represent the convective momentum. Now, all the forces are shown. First, all the surface forces are shown. Let us look at pressure, which is easier. Pressure is always compressive. So, it is acting into the control volume, it is acting into the control volume at x and x plus delta x. Now, the viscous stresses are shown, and because it is the old sign convention, on a positive face the force is along positive axis, and similarly here on a positive face force is along the positive axis. So, negative face force is along the negative axis, negative face force is along the negative axis, okay. And tau x x at x, x plus delta x, tau y x at y, tau y x y plus delta y. Okay. So, this diagram is known to us in terms of differences. Earlier we did for 3D, now it was this for 2D. Earlier we had shown the convective momentum flux separately, pressure separately, the viscous stresses separately. Now, it is 2D, all of them are put together. Okay. Okay, now, if you simplify the transient term, whatever terms we are now going to list are all per unit volume, that is after dividing by delta x, delta y, delta z. And so, the first term becomes dou by dou t rho v x. What about second term? Remember, it is net rate at which momentum leaves the control volume. So, it is out, leaving at x plus delta x, entering at x, similarly leaving at y plus delta y, entering at y. As I told you, this expression is after dividing by delta x, delta y, delta z. Okay. We have area, that area has got cancelled. So, we have delta x in the denominator. So, we have taken out minus in. The body force per unit volume is rho g x. Coming to the net force due to pressure, it is along positive x axis, this along negative x axis. So, p at x minus p at x plus delta x, positive force, negative force, okay, and divide by delta x. Okay. Once again, area divided by volume, leaving us with delta x. Now, coming to the stresses, this is positive, tau x x at x plus delta x is positive, tau x x at x is negative. So, tau x x at x plus delta x minus tau x x at x. Similarly, tau y x at y plus delta y is positive and tau y x at y is negative. And so, these are the terms for the net viscous force acting per unit volume. Now, if you substitute all of them, take limit etcetera, this we have already discussed, of course, written here for 3D. We have discussed for 2D, but writing for 3D. The transient term and then the convection term, the gravity term, the pressure term and the viscous stress term. So, this kind of recall only, we already discussed this for 3 dimensional case. Now, what do we do? Same derivation, but using the new fluid mechanics sign convention. So, let us write the integral linear momentum balance. left hand side we have the transient term, the convection term, of course no change because conceptually we are same, only sign convention is different. So, right hand side still we have gravity and the surface forces namely pressure and viscous stress. Once again I am stressing here, next slide is going to change. When you go to momentum transport, the first equation is going to change. Okay. So, once again want to say transient convection on the left hand side, gravity, pressure, viscous stress on the right hand side. Now, look at the control volume. In terms of convective momentum, no change, in and out, no change. Respective pressure, once again there is no change. Why there is no change in pressure? Always compressive, always compressive. Now, when you come to the viscous stresses, the new sign convention has been adopted. What does it mean? Once again, always the stresses are shown in a positive sense. So, on a positive face, I have shown this force acting towards negative x axis. On a negative face, I have shown this force acting towards positive x axis. Similarly, for the shear, that is for the normal stresses. Similarly, for the shear stresses, on a positive face, force is along negative x axis, on a negative y face, force is along positive x axis. So, new sign convention has been adopted to show the viscous stresses, no other difference at all compared to the previous representation. So, now transient term is same, okay. The convection term, the convective momentum term is all, the convective momentum term is also same. Remember it is out minus in. Once again I want to stress this. So, it is out minus in, net rate at which convective momentum leaves the control volume, and so we have taken what is leaving minus entering in both the directions, same as previous slide. This is also same as previous slide. Pressure, this term is also same as previous slide, compressive. So, this is positive, this is negative force. Okay. Now, when you come to the net viscous force terms, because the sign convention has changed, tau x x at x is positive, tau x x at x plus delta x is negative. So, when we write tau x x at x minus tau x x at x plus delta x, that is a key difference between the previous slide and the present slide. Similarly, for the shear stress, we have tau y x at y positive and then tau y x at y plus delta y negative, that is taken care here. Now, take limit delta x delta y delta z tending to 0, what will you get? The same left hand side, all the terms are same. Right hand side, when we take derivative for pressure, it is once again at x minus at x plus delta x. So, it is negative, same as the previous case, but for the viscous force it is at x minus at x plus delta x, which means we have a negative derivative here. In the earlier case it was at x plus delta x minus at x. So, it resulted in a positive derivative dou by dou x, but here because it is reversed we have minus dou by dou x of tau x x, and of course, all other terms are minus. So, these terms have changed compared to the previous slide because we have used a new sign convention. Earlier all the derivatives were plus, now all the derivatives are negative, okay, because of the changed sign convention.